Why is stupid ass popping willies?
What's up? Welcome back to Comedy Commentary. Today is a fucking beautiful day here in New York. And I want to talk about the fight that happened yesterday. Because Pete Davidson, our boy, the channel's boy, not my boy, was hosting. And kind of hosting. He like had a few, sorry, his fucking birds are loud. Had a few things he did yesterday for the Jake Paul Ben Askren fight. And I mean, it wasn't a Comedy Central or Netflix is a joke event. Sorry, I need to get those keywords in there. It wasn't that kind of event. It was a Triller event that I guess Jake Paul is part owner of Triller or something that he put on. Whatever. It was a fight. You know, we were all going to watch it. Doesn't matter who the fuck you were. You were going to watch it because you wanted to see what the fuck it was about. If this kid that's from YouTube could beat this UFC fighter that looks like he fucking never threw a punch in his life. Anyway, I want to talk about Pete because not just because he's a comedian. This is Comedy Commentary. Also, sorry about the delay in videos. I've been fucking moving all over the place. And now I'm finally back, hopefully making good videos. Sorry if it's a little bit windy. Pete was hosting, right? So, that was the best part about the whole fight. If you watch the event, it sucked, okay? It was bad. It was like a concert that, like, you didn't want to go to, that your school made you take a field trip to. It was that bad. And, like, Ric Flair was there, which was fun. That was good. I actually texted with my boy Dave Cyrus. You guys know who that is if you watch my fucking one interview I have on this channel. He's a good writer, and I want to say good friend, but I think he doesn't really care about me. It doesn't matter. He's a cool dude. He was nice enough to hop on the interview. Anyway, Ric Flair was there. Pete was there hosting some kind of shit. He was the host of the slap battle, which was fucking better than most of the fights that were put on. If you watch the fights, they kind of sucked. One guy faked like he got hit in the dick. Didn't go anywhere near his dick. He was fucking crying, fucking banging his fist against the ground like a big pussy. It was just bad. The event was bad. So we had to go through all that shit. Had to go through Justin Bieber's performance. Had to go through Doja Cat's performance. Had to go through that fucking Saui girl's fucking performance. It was shit. It was bad. Luckily, we had Pete Davidson there to provide some comedic relief because we really needed it after all the shitty performances. Now, I want to bring this up. He is a better actor than I had completely anticipated. After he went into Jake Paul's locker room and was like, fucking suck at Jake Paul's dick, basically, oh yeah, dude, I hate Ben Askren. He's a fucking tool bag. Hope you knock him out and shit. I was like, fuck, Pete likes this kid? I would think Pete would fucking hate this guy. Sorry, my hat kept fucking up. I thought Pete would hate this guy. You know, he's completely opposite. He's like the polar opposite of Pete Davidson. Fucking likes to be in the limelight. Likes to be famous. Fucking showing off and shit. Pete doesn't do that shit. Pete's a real celebrity. Jake Paul's a YouTuber. They've both been famous. It's actually weird. I'll make a video comparing the two fames if you want me to. Comment that below if that's what you want me to. Because it's actually crazy. They were both famous around the same age. And they both had very different career paths. But both kind of ended up in the same spot. Except Pete. I mean, you would think Pete's more famous because he was with Ariana Grande, but I digress. Anyways, he was in Jake's locker room talking about how he wanted him to knock Ben Askren out. And you're in this locker room scene with them, and you're like, fuck, Pete likes this guy. That's weird. I mean, Pete's kind of a sellout. He fucks with Jake. And then you see Pete go to Ben Askren's locker room and say, I want you to knock this guy out. I was just scared because there was 10 other guys that could fuck me up there. That's why I kind of, that's why I sounded the way I did. I was like, oh shit, fucking God, fooled me. I wouldn't think that, he would fucking be that good at acting. Well, where the fuck was that in Big Time Adolescence, Pete? Nah, I'm kidding. But that's what I thought. And I was like, shit, I texted Dave. I was like, dude, tell Pete he's a better actor than I fucking thought. Like, that shit fucking got me. But the fight was garbage if you watched it. It was just Jake hit Ben with a fucking right hand. I think it was a right hand. And then Ben hit the ground, got up, ref called it off. If you've seen Ben Askren's fights in the past, like, he got his ass dicked by Robbie Lawler. Like, Robbie Lawler's fucking pounding his head in with a 4-ounce glove. And then Ben got up and won the fight. I don't know. I think it could have continued, but who cares? They both made millions of dollars. Ben's a big crypto guy. Crypto took a dive. Now Ben got the check. He can buy all this crypto dips. He's going to make millions more. Probably more than Jake is going to make off this fight, but it doesn't fucking matter because they're both rich and we aren't. You and me, the viewer and fucking me, are not. This is the only explanation I can think of to help us in the situation. You subscribe to this channel. I get famous enough. I fight Jake Paul. I beat his ass because I probably could. That happens. Then everyone's happy. And me especially, because I'll be making a bag. Anyway, subscribe to the channel. I'll try to upload more frequently. Subscribe to my main channel. A lot of videos have been going up there. I have a new series on that channel that has been enjoyed by thousands. So, do that. Follow my socials. And I will see you guys in the next upload. Thank you and goodbye. I'm about to throw this nigga over the ledge. Bruce Willis in 6 cents. He don't know that he dead. Could let him find out for himself or I could show him instead. And I see his scared tactics. You was weird trapped. You was home sleeping on your homie air mattress. Every artist that's in the game know you an actual lame. You was a bum accent for change and that's factual lame. Heard you bought a new hairline cause it wouldn't grow no more. For them roll, you was getting jewelry out the clothing store. It took you